मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम योर डॉक्टर रहीम अहमद, फिजिक्स फैकल्टी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट एनर्जी गैप ऑफ ए सेमीकंडक्टर एक्सपेरिमेंट। ओके, व्हाट इज द एम ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट? टू डिटरमाइन द एनर्जी बैंड गैप ऑफ ए गिवन सेमीकंडक्टर। सो दिस इज द किट वेयर यू आर गोइंग टू ऑब्जर्व। सो एनर्जी गैप ऑफ ए सेमीकंडक्टर डायोड, किट नेम, एंड यू हैव हियर हीटिंग एलिमेंट, इनसाइड यू हैव सेमीकंडक्टर मटेरियल। ओके, so here see, you have the semiconductor material, it is immersed inside the oil. So see, I will take out, I will connect it here, and here we are going to measure the temperature of that part oil, means indirectly semiconductor, by using the thermometer. I have taken here apparatus, you will take out voltmeter, ammeter, semiconductor material, and your crude oil. I have taken crude oil. Okay, this is your about your circuit diagram. So power supply is connected to the voltmeter, ammeter, and your semiconductor material. Okay, so that is unknown semiconductor. The energy gap you have to find out. So that is connected in the circuit, that circuit diagram, in the box. It is internally outside it is connected by using the patch cords. So already it is connected. We will going to find out by using heating, and we are going to find out the energy gap of semiconductor. This is the formula for the energy gap of semiconductor. So energy gap equals to slope. Okay, by using the slope we are going to find out the energy gap. So remaining 1.725 into 10⁻¹⁴ is a common for constant value. Then slope you are going to find out from the graph and substitute, and simply you will get this energy gap of semiconductor. Okay, I have taken from the above formulas, I have taken energy gap semiconductor formula. Now I will going to switch on, I will show you that how you are going to connect. And I have taken some particular voltage, I will take out a constant voltage. See, I'll going to switch on and I'll show you. So I placed here some particular voltage. Okay, and so while I'll going to switch, connect the power supply. So using that board, I'll going to connect, and we will observe here. So what I have taken the voltage, I have taken particular constant value. Okay, so imagine that's your choice. What you are going to take out? Suppose I have taken 6 volts, I am taking the constant value. 6 volts you are going to take out. Okay, now it is a current value, is a maximum value you have. See that maximum value you have. Then I'll reduce somewhat a voltage, then current value will going to decrease. I'll keep it here voltage, some particular voltage like that. The current value will going to maintain here 150, means the maximum current value 150 you have. From 150 onwards, decreasing value you are getting here. Okay, now I'll going to switch on the power supply of your heater. When I'm going to switch on, inside the oil will going to heat, means semiconductor will get temperature, and that thermometer will shows you how much temperature you have. Up to 70 you are going to heat, and switch on after 70. While cooling we are going to take out the current values. While cooling you are going to take out current value, means so I have taken fixed value is of a 150 value. From 150 value I have taken the decreasing, I'm going to take out the reading. Okay, so carefully you observe. So you're going to close at the heater at 70 only. If you're going to close at 70, it will going to reach at 90 or 100, otherwise it will go for more than 100 and break down your thermometer. Okay, so now the temperature we will see here. I'll show you the table is contain the temperature in degree centigrade, and it is in Kelvin, it is in 1/T. Okay, resistance you have, log base E, current. Show you here how to take out the reading. This is the table. Every 5 degrees decreasing you have to take out the current value. 80 to 40 I have taken. 80 means 55 degrees you have to decrease, 75, 70, 65, 60, 55, like that up to 40. Your room temperature is 30 degrees, that's why I have taken 40 only. Why? Because 40 to 30 it will go for more than 1 hour. So 80 to 40, it will take half an hour or 45 minutes it will take, okay? So how to get your capital T value, capital T in Kelvin, no? Plus 273 you have to add for the degree in centigrade. Means 80 plus 273 you will get 353, 75 plus 273 you have to add. 1 by T you will take out current, and log base E current means ln. Ln, why? Because you have in the calculator, the symbol is you have ln. Okay, you don't have any log base E. That's why I have written here the table ln of current. Okay, I we have. So how to take out the graph by using these values? I'll show you here. Log base E current plus 1 by T. You will get points like that. See, maximum points we're going to cover. So we'll take out the graph like that. Some points will going to remain both the sides of your graph. Okay. So nothing will going to happen by because you have taken in maximum points we're going to cover that will we have taken the straight line. Okay, any two points you consider. So randomly you consider any two points on the line and you take out y-axis 2 points and you'll get here no x-axis 2 points. That y-axis 2 points is the current value, yes or no? Oh, current value that I have taken y2 y1. Oh, and x-axis you have taken 1 by T value temperature. So that x2 x1 I have taken the slope is you know that formula y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. Okay, so that value you will take out and directly you substitute inside the formula. So slope into some 1.7 you will get here. You will get the slope energy gap of a semiconductor. Okay, students, drawn here the graph. I'll show you that 1 by T versus see here the values you have common is 10 to power of minus 6. You have I have taken here log base current. They have taken so equally divided the your scale. That's your choice how you are going to divide your scale. Okay, though the scale how you are divided that you have to write down here. The scale is very important. X-axis 1 unit is how much you have taken, y-axis 1 unit how much you have taken. So by using this graph they found that slope. Okay, so they have started with 0, that's why they haven't written here in the x-axis origin, y-axis origin. Okay, so x-axis 1 unit equals to 0.5, y-axis is they have taken 0.3. Okay, the straight line, see maximum points are covered, 1 point is outside from the line. How they are calculated the slope y2 minus 1 by x2 minus x1 they calculated and they got here some value of 5.03 18 24 of value. Okay, that value substitute inside the formula. Formula you know that slope equivalent to 1.725 into 10 to power of minus 4. So they are substituting here the value of the slope. They got 0.8 into 0.8 value into some electron volts. You will get electron volts you have to convert. Okay, what is the value you are getting for the germanium? You know that what is the exact value for the band gap. Okay, now see that band gap nearly you will get here 0.7 you have to get, but some practically we'll see here the 0.6 0.7 you will get. Okay, similarly for the silicon 1.1 electron volts you have to get. Practically, we will see here 1.02, 1.1015, not 1.1312 up to that point it is going to allow. Okay, so in the result they are placing that what they got the value, that is 0.8726. Okay, that is the means the unknown semiconductor is a germanium material. Okay, this is the way, very easy way we are going to find out the exact value of this semiconductor. So by heating. Okay, while heating we are going to take out. Okay, so why you are not taking heating sir, why you are taking only cooling means rapidly increasing temperature it's very difficult to take out the current values, but that's why always we are going to take out the while cooling we are taking the current readings. Okay, so thank you very much and go for my channel Dr. Rahim Ahmed and you will get other experiments also. Thank you.